and are you ready? This is the almost in time. I'm not really sure what that means. Almost in time? Oh, almost in time, like one, two. So one of you doesn't play in time? I'm going for the saxophone. As long as the vocalist is on time, great. They were all here this morning on time, too, so we're happy about that. We're going to let them lead us into worship with the opening song that you can sit back or stand and jump around or dance with your partner or your neighbor or whatever. I do want to warn you, I'll have some announcements after this. Go ahead.
$5 for youth,
We really want you to walk in and drop one. So pick up a packet here. I'll raise some money as well. That's going to be narthex. We have a chili cook-off coming up that I need 17 people to help cook chili. I have some already and I need more. Tell me after church, Chris Dupre is volunteering. And remember, he cooks award-winning chili. Not just regular chili, award-winning chili. So talk to me if you'll be one of those cooks. There's information on page 7. Next Sunday is confirmation orientation at 9 o'clock for 7th, 8th, and 9th graders here in the sanctuary. It is also the Sunday that Madison Urban Ministry Baking Group will be selling their great bakery products. And remember, we support that by hosting them for their classroom activities on Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. And then they bake their items at the new Feed Kitchen down on Sherman Avenue. And then I do want to draw your attention to page 4. Our new office administrator, Laura, will begin on the 22nd of September. And that following Sunday morning, September 28th, we will have a reception welcoming her at 9:30 a.m. in the fellowship room. And then we'll introduce her at the 10 o'clock, 10:30 worship service here in the sanctuary. And we want to do something a little fun for Laura, and we want to stock her pantry. So bring something that you think Laura should have in her pantry. Maybe it's something good, maybe it's something you want to get rid of, I don't know. Be nice, will ya? Think of some fun things to send home with Laura. We don't want to make it too obnoxious. We just thought a little fun thing for her would be really great. If you haven't signed up for the Woldersheim Winery Tour, don't forget to do that out in the entry. And don't forget to sign up for the senior cookout and Euchre tournament coming up also on the 22nd. And remember, everybody's invited to come to choir on Thursday nights at 7 o'clock. Our music director is sitting in the sanctuary today. It is the first time she's ever been able to just sit back with her family. Sorry that that's your sister, but what can I do? But the same is, and so Lynn's excited about doing that. I'm going to invite you now to get off your ropes and move them a little as we sing the opening hymn along with Nancy and the rest of the band. So stand up! Thank you.
see this new day. Open my ears to hear the birds. Open my nose to smell the incense. Open my heart to love and worship you, the one who has given me Christ, to know that I will live in your glory. Strengthen our faith in this promise, and keep me walking close to you. In the name of Christ, amen.
The congregation may be seated if you would like to have a seat. This would be an excellent time. No, don't see me off, because I've been preaching a little while. Just because the people around you are sleeping doesn't make it okay. I thought I heard God saying, those Lutherans are having a good time at Lakeview this morning. I'm glad I'm there. Yeah. And today our reading comes from the 14th chapter of Romans. Welcome those who are weak in faith, but not for the purpose of quarreling over opinions. Some believe in eating anything, while the weak eat only vegetables. Those who eat must not despise those who abstain, and those who abstain must not pass judgment on those who eat, for God has welcomed them. Who are you to pass judgment on servants of another? It is before their own Lord that they stand or fall, and they will be upheld, for the Lord is able to make them stand. Some judge one day to be better than another, while others judge all days to be alike. Let all be fully convinced in their own minds. Those who observe the day, observe it in honor of the Lord, and those who eat, eat in honor of the Lord, since they give thanks to God, while those who abstain, abstain in honor of the Lord and give thanks to God. We do not live to ourselves, and we do not die to ourselves. If we live, we live to the Lord, and if we die, we die to the Lord. So then whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. For to this end, Christ died and lived again, so that he might be Lord of both the dead and the living. Why do you pass judgment on your brother or sister? Or you, why do you despise your brother or sister? For we will all stand before the judgment seat of God. For it is written, as I live, says the Lord, every knee shall bow to me, and every tongue shall give praise to God. So then each of us will be accountable to God. And I invite Christine Stamm to come forward and do you want kids to come up?
She needs kids
of all kinds, shapes, sizes, ages, and not too old.
Darn it. Okay. If you are wearing red,
Mandrake Rd?
Oh, yeah.
All right, you can wrap a special miter ring and go into the fabulous fort. If you're seven years old, you can grab a spider ring. Go on in. That's not all of us. Number four. If you live in Sun Prairie, you can grab. All right.
Because there is no bathroom in this building.
and the flowers in my backyard. Don't they look good? Isn't that a beautiful picture? Doesn't it make you just want to come into my backyard and enjoy it? Unless, of course, you're blind. Because then it would look like this. Today we gather back together after finding a lot of rest and refreshment and relaxation, and even some of you did some camping. I did not. Throughout the summer, this is just rally week, and we come back and we rally together around worship, around the meal this morning, around new programming this fall. Today we can focus on the words of the author of Romans, the author who says, "Do not pass judgment, for God has welcomed them." As we begin this new program here at Lakeview, I've got an idea. Let's establish a New Year's resolution. It's the new year. A lot of you have tried that on the 1st of January, and then on the 2nd of January, you give it up. Okay? Alright? Because you step on the scales and nothing happened. But here, let's be dedicated to this New Year's resolution. What if we work even harder this year at not passing judgment on people and at welcoming everyone? If God can welcome everyone, why can't we try to do it as well? If we are people of God who claim to use Jesus as the model in all those wonderful stories, then it appears that we would have no other choice but to review everything that happens here and to work toward hospitality and welcome. We have an obligation as disciples to establish an environment at Lakeview that is safe, that is non-judgmental, that is warm and comfortable for everyone to come and to find out about God's love. To find out that God's love is so huge, so gigantic, so enormous, that even I, a sinful, crazy, a little bit sarcastic, however lost my beer-drinking, sandal-wearing, blonde-haired Lutheran, can be the recipient of that love. Yes, even I, with all my faults, and I have a lot of them that you don't even know of, I can come to the table of our Lord and be reminded week after week that I am forgiven because God loves me. And as that Romans reading told us this morning, even vegetarians, and you know who you are, should not be judged or despised. Good news, Mary and Dana. Sometimes we don't think about the obstacles or the barriers that churches put up to prevent others from feeling welcome. Some of them are pretty easy. They're pretty obvious. We know them. Like refusing to recognize the equality between men and women. Or the refusal to share prayer or communion with those of another tradition. Or the homophobic attitudes that sometimes permeate certain religious groups in our world. We're also aware of some of the physical barriers that churches establish, like steps, or the lack of bathrooms, or the lack of a Braille worship book, or the lack of an interpreter who can assist those who are hearing impaired, or even communion rails where sometimes people are expected to kneel. Those are barriers, and they're the common ones. But this year at Lakeview, what about if we go a little deeper than all that? How about if we consider attitudes that might be exclusionary? What if we think about this year how political positions can exclude? What about if we think about those awful words, and to me they are awful words, conservative and liberal? And how do those words exclude others? Well, let's think about expectations regarding what dress might be in this place. I know that's kind of hard when I'm standing here in a t-shirt, shorts, and sandals, okay? But sometimes expectations about a dress code are exclusionary. Or what are expectations about the behavior of children? How might that exclude? Or what about the stereotypes that people hold about those who are elderly or those who are disabled? And how might those ideas and thoughts be exclusionary? Have we really seriously considered how the ideology that can suggest that Lutherans are the ideology that would suggest that Christians are superior in this world, how is that theology exclude in our community? What about Christian arrogance? Maybe we should talk about that this year. Or maybe we could talk about the attitudes that surround us, that exist, that oppress people who are poor, or who are not citizens of this nation, or who don't speak English, or whose skin color is different from your own, or who would like to marry someone of the same gender. Creating a warm, inclusive, welcoming environment like the one Jesus modeled for us all the time will require us to think about our human desire, the desire that we have to retaliate, to get revenge against those that we believe have done us wrong, or those who we might call enemy. This inclusive, welcoming environment that we'd like to establish will not be an easy task. And I'm sure nobody ever told you that following the Christ was going to be an easy task. It is far easier to stay far away from the church world than to come and be a part of it for that reason and for many others. But I'm glad. I'm not always very glad, but I'm really glad today that you have chosen to be part of this community of the faithful here on the hill. And I look forward to this new year, a new year, and an exciting year again at Lakeview. I look forward to partnering with all of you as we share bread and wine every time we get together. And as we build houses, and as we offer space for people who are homeless to sleep in, and as we provide food and meals to those who struggle, and as we collect blood like we just did this last Tuesday, good job, way to go, Lakeview, and as we enjoy social fellowship, even if it is on a boat on the river in Milwaukee, and we're sampling some beverages along the way. All of those things I look forward to in this coming year. And I even look forward to doing some stupid things with you this year. Now, I won't be leading that, but several of you are really good at stupid. You know who you are. And to set the tone, we're going to pass toilet paper this morning. It doesn't get much stupider than that. But I look forward to those opportunities. Because here's what I believe. I believe that this year, at some point, somebody is going to feel warm and welcome in this place because they get several of these rolls of toilet paper in their food package on Monday night, and they were in great need. God loves you. All of you. Amen. I'll invite the band to come back forward. Linda, wake up. Linda's a dear friend, so if you feel like I'm picking on her too much, I am. And the congregation can stand when ready, and we're going to sing along with Nancy as she directs us. Thank you. I'll invite Amy Lutke forward. Oh, Nancy, we're going to borrow your mic again. Generally, Amy is loud enough, but just be sure.
Can we have the following Sunday school teachers come forward, please? Nate Campbell, Aubrey Devine Scott, John Dyer, Monica Dyer, Jenny Evans, Brenda Haslow, Lynn Najum, Annette Donnell, Nancy Stilwell, and Megan Barnhart. And anyone else who would like to be a Sunday school teacher. We'll take as many as we can get.
Carol? Oliver is going to teach too. Cool. We have a chance to install you into your volunteer position this year, and we're grateful. Dear Christian friends, baptized into the priesthood of Christ, we are all called to offer ourselves to the Lord of the Church in thanksgiving for what God has done and continues to do for us. It is our privilege to recognize and support those this morning who are engaged in work in this congregation, especially those engaged in the ministry of education. Now, teachers and Sunday school staff, having offered yourselves in the Sunday school ministry of this congregation, will you follow our Lord's example of home service? If so, together answer yes with God's help.
Yes, with God's help.
Members of the congregation, will you pray for these teachers, these volunteers this week, and will you support their work in our Sunday school program and offer them your love and encouragement? If so, answer yes with God's help.
Yes, with God's help.
Good. I think everybody agreed. Is there anybody that missed that? Steve? All right, let us pray. Almighty God, source of wisdom and knowledge, help us to study your word diligently and to grow in your love and in all that is good. Support all who teach and all who learn, that together we may know and do your will. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. As our staff returns to their seats, you may thank them for their volunteerism and your love. It is time for the blessing of the toilet paper. You're the dark words, I'm the light words. We give thanks for your creation, Lord, and for the trees that grace our world.
We give thanks for paper, Lord, made from trees creation.
Guide us to use resources wisely to save trees and protect any of your creation that is in danger. Make us grateful to be able to share our gifts with those who are struggling.
Continue to bless our food pantry, volunteers, and all those who make use of this resource. Amen.
And the good news is, it's all clean this year. Thank you for being sure of that. I'll invite the band to play something as the ushers receive the morning offering.
Let me take you to Alexander's Grandstand.
just any church until you hear Kurt and Alexander's ragtime band. Please rise as we pray. Let us pray now. Great God, look with favor on your church throughout the world. Gather us to be your people who share your forgiveness and love with everyone, even when that may be difficult. Make your church and all its leaders honest to your word. Lord, in your mercy. Great God, we give thanks for this congregation and its members and volunteers, and particularly those who will lead our education programs this year. Watch over all our children and youth. Thank you for all musicians, including those who are sharing their gifts this weekend in the Almost in Time Dixieland Jazz Band. Lord, in your mercy. Great God, this week we continue to remember the events in our nation that happened on September 11th, 2001. We remember those who died, those who have been injured, and those who live with that loss. We remember the impact that event has had on the world. We also lift up all those people who have worked and who continue to work at bringing healing and wholeness back to our society. We pray for war, hatred, terror, and killing to end. We pray for a safe and humanitarian way to deal with ISIS and the continuing conflict in the Middle East. Lord, in your mercy. O God, as we prepare for the Madison Crop Walk, open our eyes to hunger in the world. Open our hearts to be empathetic. Then open our mouths, hands, feet, and pocketbooks to respond to hunger in all kinds of ways. We pray that all people who are oppressed will find safety and justice because of our work. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Great God, comfort those who are grieving this morning. Bring hope and healing to all who struggle with addictions, health, loneliness, and depression, including Mark Malley, Jerry Fenske, Kathy Shine, Betty Smith, Debbie, and anyone else whom we now name in the silence of our hearts. Lord, in your mercy, we give thanks, O Lord, that you hear us when we pray. Amen. On the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread. He gave thanks and broke it, and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body. It's given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." And again, after supper, he took the cup. He gave thanks, and he gave it for all of them to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of your sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. This is the table of the Lord, and the Lord invites all to come and dine this morning. The meal is served by intention. Receive the wafer, dip it into the red wine or the white juice, and return to your seats using the side aisles. I would ask five servers and any band members who wish to commune to come and stand at the center. The congregation may be seated.
The body of Christ given. 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 Body of Christ, give it. Body of Christ, give it.
Thank you.
Please rise for the concluding prayer. May this body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in God's grace.
Amen.
Thank you, God, for the food we've eaten and the confidence to know that you love us and will bring us into your kingdom. Give us happy hearts, hands, feet, and voices. Make us joyful to fulfill our baptismal call to do your work for justice in this place. Watch over us as we proclaim your love with our words and our actions. Hear our prayer, O God.
Amen.
Okay, this service ends with what we're called to do, go out and serve. And so today, before we go home, we're going to serve. We've made it, and so it's not complicated. Most of you will get it just fine. I'm going to call Randy Matthews and Amy and Ben and Dane and Steve Ewert to come forward. And they're going to lead you out, and please fall in line right behind them. Ben, you'd be a great person to just start right in the line behind them. We're going to make a line from this point to the food pantry, and we're going to be passing the toilet paper. If you would like to sit down and pass, we'll pass right across this front row. You got to be a senior or disabled to sit. You cannot sit just because you had a tough morning. Okay, so sit right here, lead the way, following right behind them. And as this is all happening, we invite the band to play and sing, and we're going to sing pass. Okay, here we go. Right there by the freedom.
Hallelujah day. Madison.